Ladies and gentlemen, we've hit the midpoint of the NHL season a while ago.
We're a little past that.
A little past it. But this is the best moment to talk about the NHL standings because this is the time when teams are cementing their place in the playoff picture.
Yeah.
That being the case, this is Prediction Center, and as usual, we predict. We try to predict anyway.
Yeah.
It doesn't always work, but you know, that's the fun of sports. You never know what's going to happen.
Yeah.
So that being said, let's dive right in. There's two conferences to cover. East-West. Let's start with the East. The East is what I like to call the boring, stale conference.
Yeah.
There's very few surprises in the Eastern Conference.
No.
So let me start with you, Dave. Who do you think is going to win the Metropolitan?
Metropolitan, all right. Well, I'll kick it off. I think Washington is going to take it. They've been hot all year. I don't know if they're still currently on a losing streak, but they were recently on a losing streak, if not that, 5 games, I believe.
They lost 5 of 6, because the Pats played them
yesterday. But before that, weren't they on like a 10-game winning streak?
Yeah, 4 or 5 games.
They didn't lose at home until like 2 weeks ago or
whatever. Hey, whatever. It's hard to maintain a strong level of play throughout the whole year. They're stumbling a little bit now. I don't think it's going to be that big of an issue. Washington, number one for me. Number two, Pittsburgh Penguins, the current reigning, defending Stanley Cup champions. They are, how many points behind? 1 point behind Columbus for second in the Met. They're red hot, and they're a very dangerous team. I think they're going to be a sleeper, even though they shouldn't be. A lot of people should take them seriously, but for some reason they're not being talked about that much. And third, Columbus. They're having a great year. Do I think they're going to do anything in the playoffs? That's yet to be seen. But Columbus, for me, is number three. So Washington, Pittsburgh, Columbus.
How about you, Mike?
Well, I'll agree with you on the number one. I got Washington. Obviously, they have probably one of the more, like, I guess, stacked teams in the league.
Prolific offense.
Amazing offense, great defense. They even just got Shattenkirk from trade deadline. Great goal.
They have less than 160 goals against.
That's
amazing.
I mean,
that's
and they probably have like close to like 250 goals for. So like
it's 223.
They're probably going to get 250 by the end of the season, at least. Pretty obvious choice. Number two, I got Columbus. I don't know, they have a lot of young talent. I know like they have like Werenski, all these like random guys you never hear about that are just like producing and doing really well. So it's really impressive what they're doing, and Tortorella's really like kind of galvanized that team, and like I said, they're riding hot. And number three, I got the Stanley Cup champion Pittsburgh Penguins. Obviously, like you said, a team that needs to be taken account for. Their speed is the best in the league, and it's definitely going to show in the playoffs. So I got that team.
My picks are the exact same, in the sense that it's Washington, Columbus, Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh, Columbus, I'm not going to really pick a ranking. I mean, I'm not sure where either one
it could go.
If I had to, I would say that I think Columbus will hang on to the number two spot.
You do think so?
Yeah,
okay.
I feel like their schedule is just easier down the stretch.
Yeah.
And Pittsburgh's got more eyes watching. I don't know. I hope that, I really feel that of those three teams, there's a high chance that one of those three teams will go to the Cup Final.
Yeah.
There's a very high chance.
Yeah.
When you look at their comparisons to the Eastern Conference, they have the most goals for and the least goals against.
Mm-hmm.
Like, one of these teams is
the best
statistical
teams,
best. Yeah. So, you want to say Washington, how far will they go? Because, every year they're great, and then nothing happens.
Yeah.
But they really stacked it this year.
Yeah.
Like, if we said last year, now's the time. If this isn't the time, then there is no time.
Yeah.
Anyway, so I say Washington, Columbus, Pittsburgh. Let's see what's happening in the Atlantic Division.
Next up, we got our division, even though you're not wearing the shirt. Atlantic Division.
Yeah.
Where my Senators and their Habs reside. Kick us off. What do you have?
I'm a expatriate. I love the Montreal Canadiens, but I like the West Coast games, man. They're on later, and it's sunnier, and it looks nicer.
Sure.
And we're not in misery in the cold. But if I had to pick the top three, it's the classic top three of the last probably 10 years. Besides the Lightning are usually in this picture.
Mm.
It's like the Senators, the Lightning, and Bruins always like kind of swap out in the last few years.
Yeah.
But this year, the Ottawa Senators have been really, really, really good team. Canadians started really strong and faltered, but it looks like they're going to hold on to that first position. I think Ottawa and Boston will finish second, third. Again, it could be any mix of those three, but it's set as those are the top three, seems. That being said, where everybody goes, I really like Ottawa. Ever since Craig Anderson has been facing that adversity, the team's like rallied around that, kind of made that a storyline, kind of like the 98 Red Wings with Konstantinov, you know?
Yeah.
So, I mean, it could be something, something to look at. It would be great for Dave since 2007. He's been
10 years this year? Jesus Christ.
Yeah, it's already 10 years.
We are getting so old.
Since I was making jokes of Niedermeyer shooting the fucking
quack,
off his face.
Quack, quack on my locker in high school. Bunch of pricks.
Yeah, what can you say? But, and Boston too can give a good run for the money. I think Montreal got hot early and now is really, it's lost its identity, it doesn't know what it's about.
Yeah.
Whereas Boston and Ottawa are figuring themselves out real quick.
Yeah.
So I think that's a big thing to look at. How about you, Mike?
I'll agree with your top three. Mm-hmm. Montreal, I just feel like the worst thing that could happen is them winning division because they're going to have to face another really good Metropolitan
team. A hungry
team,
yeah.
And, most likely New York. So I think that's going to happen. Obviously, Ottawa, Boston. Boston kind of faltered a little bit, but Ottawa has just been very consistent throughout the whole season. I said it from the beginning.
Trying not to like laugh and smile. I just want to like, I don't want to jinx anything.
Yeah.
I just want things to stay the same. And just like,
I said it when you guys hired Guy Boucher. I told him, I'm like, the first thing you guys are going to do is go to the conference finals. Every single year.
Well,
his first year in power. He always
some of the
go
lowest goals
so.
Against in the league. You know,
mm-hmm.
177, that's very low.
Yeah. Erik Karlsson leads the league in block shots.
Yeah, which is kind of...
He's changing everything, right?
Kind of crazy when you think about his offense.
Yeah.
That he's also the leader of block shots.
Yeah.
He's Volchenkov-ing.
He is. Picking up from the A-train.
Josh Georges.
Yeah.
No, he's not useless. So you got Montreal,
yeah.
Ottawa, Boston.
Yeah.
All right, so I got the exact same thing, Montreal, Ottawa, Boston.
The East is bored.
It is bored, but I will say this. Montreal, Ottawa have 3 games left to play against each other.
That's true.
Starting this weekend, probably at the time of the release of the video. And Ottawa has 2 games in hand, plus 3 head-to-heads.
That's true.
So that could be 5 games in hand if they win all 3. I don't think they will. I think somehow Montreal's going to pull it out and really piss me off.
Yeah.
And take it. But I kind of want them to win the division so they can play the Rangers.
Yeah.
But then we would probably play the Leafs and we'd probably get screwed.
No, you're going to play Boston.
Oh, you're right. Yeah, we're not playing the wildcard team. You're right.
Yeah,
yeah. My bad. Yeah, you're right. So yeah, Montreal, Ottawa, Boston.
Yeah, let's look at the wildcard picture. So now we're looking at the wildcard for the Eastern Conference. And strangely enough, the Leafs are in the playoff mix.
It's not a lockout shortened year.
Yeah, it's incredible.
Yeah.
That being said, they're 12 points behind the Rangers, which is kind of a bummer because when you think about it, like the Metropolitan really is rounded out by the Rangers, and that's about it. Whereas the Atlantic Division is rounded out by, basically the Leafs and
Tampa.
Panthers, I mean, but yeah, sorry, Tampa Bay Lightning.
The other Florida team.
Yeah, I mixed them up. But yeah, Tampa Bay. Tampa Bay is not the Tampa we've known in the past.
No.
You know, injuries had to do with that. That being said, they are currently, at the time of this video, at 77 points. The Leafs are currently at 78. Leafs have a game in hand.
They do, I did not realize that right now. Yep.
Yeah, so when you think about that, you gotta ask a lot of questions. Who do you see pulling it off?
Well, I think we could all agree the Rangers are the undisputed number one wildcard team.
If not moving up to the third.
Potentially. And number two, I'm going to give it to Tampa. I think Stamkos coming back, even if he's not game ready, you know, him practicing and being, you know, in the with the locker room with the boys and being around them and rallying them, he's their captain. I think they're going to pull it through, and I think Toronto, they've been sluggish lately. They win 2-3 games, they lose 5 games. They win 2-3 games,
by
they lose
huge
5
margins,
games.
Like 7-4.
That team is it's up and coming, but there's still a lot of holes, and they're still 2-3 years away from being a real contender. Tampa's my second choice.
I would agree with you just on the sole basis that if Stamkos were to return for, like, let's say game 78 or 79, and it's still this close, I would give the edge to Tampa.
Yeah.
Because I feel like they could pull a stretch run and close the gap.
Yeah.
Well, they're doing it now. Right?
Yeah, they're currently
they're
closing the gap. So
getting hot,
man. You know, weird that they got rid of Bishop.
Vasilevskiy's been playing great, though.
Yeah, but it's weird. But, I mean, the time has to come, right? So
I think it's more expansion draft than anything
else. I think that last wild card spot is just a really weird place to be. I mean, the Islanders are technically in it. I don't consider them... They're kind of a they have a team with no identity. But actually, just remember this stat. that makes it interesting. They've won more games than any team in the NHL since they fired their coach.
Really?
That's a fact.
Oh, shit.
So
yeah, they're bottom of the East.
Yeah, they were bottom of the East, and now they're within reach. So that could be an interesting storyline. If we have a New York wild card,
that'd be cool.
That would be pretty cool.
Yeah.
So I mean, how realistic is it? I don't know, because you know we all know how stats work. Yeah, they've won the most games, but all that takes is an injury or foot off the gas, and they're back up.
Yeah.
So that being said, I like Tampa the way that they're a good team. They have all these great players. Palat and Johnson and
Kucherov
and Stamkos, if he comes back, they got it. They've been to the Stanley Cup Finals recently with the same team, with the same
conference finals last year.
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, that being said, Tampa Bay.
Yeah, honestly, I'm going to agree with you guys completely. I know it kind of sounds like we're like copying out a little
bit. It's the East. The East is that way.
But like, honestly, like, I thought Tampa this year, like, the fact that they're at the bottom is just a really off year.
Yeah.
They're one of the most, I think, one of the most talented teams in the East. I still think they're more dangerous than many teams in the East besides maybe Washington and Pittsburgh. I think they're like the number three, regardless of what happened this year. So I'm picking them as the last wild card. Obviously, the Rangers are, you know, the undisputed number one wild card. But man, Tampa is dangerous. Like I said, Kucherov is having a really good year. We all know what happens with Johnson, Palat in the playoffs. They become amazing, you know, so like they have a really good team, so like I said, I'm going with them.
Let's see if they can get lightning in a bottle. Let's move on to the Western Conference now. We're in the Western Conference now. We've flown over 3 hours, and yeah, here we are. So
well, the Central's right in between that, so not
that's
really
true. We're on the way.
Yeah.
So the Central Division, being the first one we're going to talk about,
Michael's division,
is a division that's been owned by one team for quite a long time.
And one City Wings?
They've been owned by, well, the that's true. Yeah, the Red Wings.
Exactly.
Before they left. But we're all talking about Chicago.
We're all talking about Chicago.
The great city of Chicago. One of, if not the best cities, to start with the letter C.
Absolutely, yeah.
Not only that, but every sports team that they have needed let people know that they have a C, you know, like the Bears, the C, the Blackhawks with the C on their shoulders.
The Cubs, you know.
The
White Sox don't have a C.
Because I think,
they just
have
socks.
I think the people there are too stupid to understand that the city starts with a C, so they're just
very,
it's like a reminder.
Yeah,
you know?
Just the biggest
well, hey, I'm offended by that, because the Montreal Canadiens are a C, which is weird. Anyway.
Which is weird.
Doesn't the C start with an M?
Chicago is continuing its dominance of hockey in general. They are not as impressive this year, for example.
No, they are now.
Yeah, now.
But not earlier, but
they're
now.
Kind of, it's like a quiet season.
Patrick Kane has, 17 goals in his last, 15 games or something crazy like that.
Yeah.
Like, the guy's on fire.
He's killing it. But add to this the fact that we're you know, like, it's hard to be impressed by things that are already good. Right?
Yeah, you're right,
But
our standards are already really high.
They've kept the same team basically intact for a long, long time.
Yeah, somehow.
Yeah,
in the
like seven or 8 years of the same team.
Yeah.
Very good job by their management.
Yeah, stand the man.
So that being said, you know, I think they have a great shot at keeping the first place of the Central Division.
Yeah.
Where it starts to get interesting, second and third place. Minnesota and Nashville are not very close, but
But
Nashville is holding down that number three spot, and they're holding it down pretty well. I mean, they've been playing really, really good hockey.
As of late, yeah.
Very, very good. Philip Forsberg turned it on. He's running away with it. And,
almost Patrick Kane-esque.
And what's inspiring is that Bruce Boudreau is a piece of flaming garbage as a coach.
In the playoffs.
Yeah,
in the playoffs.
It's true, it's true. Regular season, he tends to...
It's like Barry Trotz.
Yeah, but I feel like he just rides good teams.
Yeah.
So, I mean...
Like Barry Trotz.
Minnesota has a great...
Yeah, Barry Trotz had really
Minnesota
good
has a great goalie. I think they have the least goals against in the league, could it be? 170?
Same thing like last year with the Ducks, these goals against, and they had the best special teams.
Yeah, and they're plus 56, but even the Capitals always used to be like these huge pluses, and then you get to the playoffs and they can't do anything.
They lost to the Montreal Canadiens in 2010.
Exactly. So,
good times.
You know, I don't know. You got to look at who gets hot at the right time. Minnesota's been consistent, and usually consistency doesn't pay off for some reason in the playoffs. It really doesn't. So either way, that's about their deep run. We're talking about predictions on finishing. I think it's going to be the exact teams that are currently in first, second, and third are going to finish at first, second, and third. Chicago, Minnesota. Nashville. LSU. Maybe that's a sign from God. He said Nashville's gonna finally get it out.
Yeah.
They're gonna make it to the conference finals and maybe a cup final. Who knows? They also the All Star game, which is always a good sign.
Yeah, so it seems to be. Yeah. Michael.
I'm gonna agree with you guys. I was actually hoping Chicago would win division because I really didn't want to play them in the first round. But yeah, I think it's gonna stay this way.
That. It might change my prediction. Oh, shit.
Chicago. Chicago's a. Can I talk?
Yeah, go ahead. Okay. Didn't have a good laugh to later on.
Chicago is obviously the they're getting hot. They've been playing really well the past 20 or so games. I think they're like 15-3 the past 18 games. So they've been really doing well. Minnesota, as you said, has been consistent. Winning two, losing one, winning two, losing one type thing, which is really good. Like I said, I don't know how far it's been taking the playoffs. Remains to be seen. Nashville's been coming along lately after really, really rough patches. October was horrible for us. December was horrible.
Yeah, no Subban early on, right? So.
It's not only that, just goaltending wise, just wasn't there. Everything we were kind of out of the loop. But now we're starting to find our identity back. We're playing better. So I think it's going to stay like this. I sure hope it does.
Wouldn't the ultimate slap in the face to the Montreal fans be if Subban, in the first season as a Predator, took them all the way? Wouldn't that be an interesting storyline?
I wish, but I would say that, like, I don't know if we have it in us.
I don't know either, but I'm just saying, wouldn't that be a great
So you got Chicago, Minnesota, Nashville.
Yeah, I'm keeping it as is.
Well, I'm going to agree. Same thing. You guys basically said everything I was saying, but I will say this. If Chicago does finish second and we get another Chicago-Nashville matchup, oh man, it's going to be a party in this house.
Yeah, it's going to be
a party.
First of all, how does that keep happening?
I don't know.
Something's wrong with the system if that keeps happening.
What happens is that the Preds never get a break in the first two rounds. We play the hardest teams.
Yeah, remember that year you played Detroit and they won the Stanley Cup?
And then we played Detroit when they went to the cup final. Like, it's unbelievable. We get no breaks. You guys in the East are like, have it easy.
All right. So we all got whatever standings are at now. Chicago, Minnesota, Nashville. Let's move on to the Pacific. Next up, Pacific.
The greatest division.
Not the greatest division, but... all right, so who do you guys have, Pacific?
I'm going to say, for the first time in many years, that I don't know if I see the LA Kings in the playoff picture. I always pick them, even if they're out of the picture.
What are you doing?
But this year, I don't know, it's been a confusing one.
No.
They got to play better.
You guys
have been playing good lately.
Yeah, they have, yeah. Since Bishop. Yeah.
But I don't know. But I don't think they're going to finish top 1, 2, 3 in the Pacific Division.
No.
They're not going to catch third. Now, that being said, it's a pretty good dogfight for that 2-3 spot because it's very close between Anaheim, Edmonton, and Calgary. There's a 2-point gap in those three teams.
Yeah.
I don't like Anaheim, how they're playing this year. They've been just lukewarm.
Yeah.
For a long time.
Winning
now.
Close games.
They're like, you're a good team, but nothing more than that.
Yeah.
They're not scary anymore. They're not.
Last year was their last year. I found to like make a huge run.
Yeah.
And I'm glad my team ended that.
Well, to be fair, I mean, I know looking back, the 10-year anniversary of them winning the cup, a lot of people consider it one of the best teams ever assembled. But I mean, at the time, no one was talking about it.
Yeah.
It was after the fact.
Yeah.
People were talking.
Thing is with them now, with their road record.
Terrible.
It's terrible. Jesus Christ.
So, I mean, you know, if
that's
you can't
win. That's an Eastern Conference road record.
Yeah. If you can't win outside of your stupid pond, what does that tell you? So, you know, San Jose's a lock to win the first place, I think.
Yeah.
They're like 10 points ahead of third.
Mm-hmm.
I think Edmonton will end up finishing. Stay third, but Calgary's been so hot lately. I think they're gonna leapfrog into second.
Really?
Yeah, I really.
And Anaheim's gonna drop down.
Gonna drop out of the top three. Yeah, so I think it's gonna be San Jose, Calgary, and Edmonton. I think we're gonna finally see some
Little
Canadian
Alberta.
Flags waving.
Considering last year there was
and wouldn't
zero.
It be great to start the Stanley Cup playoffs with
the Battle of Alberta?
The Battle of Alberta. Would that not be something? You don't think the CBC is working on that right now?
On the 100th year anniversary.
They are injuring
NHL.
Ducks left and right. Let me tell you. They're doing it. So,
Michael?
That's my Don Cherry moment.
Well, obviously, San Jose is probably going to run away with it. They have a 7-point lead. They're probably
the most talented team. Maybe in the league. Maybe in the league. They just obviously came off a finals appearance. They should be, favorites to come out of the West, them and Chicago, respectively. Like I said, Anaheim's kind of lukewarm, but I think that they're getting there and they're consistent, so I think they're going to stay there at the number two spot. Calgary's been hot. They just won 10 straight. They recently lost to Boston, but basically throughout the past month, they've been amazing. So I think they're going to overtake Edmonton for that number three spot, but I'm hoping for what you said, which is the Battle of Alberta in the first round. That'd be pretty epic, but I don't see it happening. I see Edmonton dropping down to one of the wild cards.
So you got San Jose, Anaheim, Calgary?
Calgary.
Yeah, I got literally the exact same thing. Calgary's doing well.
They're on fire. Flames are on fire.
Yeah. We'll see though if it's going to be a similar trend to what they were 2 years ago when they were really hot, and then last year they completely vanished. I have a rule in all sports where you need to do things 2 years in a row to prove your consistency and to prove that you're a contender. Doing it 2 out of 3 years is not so bad, but the playoffs are going to be a true test for them and see how far they can actually get into that. So, I agree with you guys. San Jose, Anaheim, Calgary.
One of the wild card spots for the West.
Last up, Western Conference, wild card.
Instant depression. The LA Kings are probably not going to make it in.
No, probably not.
We got the St. Louis Blues who decided to dump Shattenkirk.
Yep.
They said, hey, Shattenkirk, no more of you. Nope. We're tired of it. But they still have the Tarasenko show, which makes them very dangerous.
Only a plus one.
Yeah.
They've been terrible. Wow. Just that they have that guy.
On the road, 17.
Yeah. They have Tarasenko.
17-17 on the road. Yeah. Jesus Christ, not doing that great.
But, remember, they fired their coach. I think they did it a bit late. Because you know how teams used to just fire the coach like 5 games in the season and win the Stanley Cup that year? It was classic NHL for like 4 straight seasons that happened. And then now the trend is broken.
Not Chicago.
Yeah. but they were the exception that proves the rule.
Yeah.
so I'm going to go ahead and pick, as I said, Anaheim is probably going to get bumped out of the Pacific top three and get bumped into wild card contention.
Mm-hmm.
I think they're going to make it there. And I really think St. Louis has the chops to hang on and make it in barely.
Yeah.
I don't know how much noise they'll make again. I think they'll just be fodder for the Blackhawks like a couple of years back when they just ran right over them.
Yep.
I think they swept
them. Looks like they're going to be playing. Yeah, they're going to be playing the Blackhawks.
Yeah, so it's one of those classic playoff matchups that just happens over and over again.
I think it'd be like the 12th time they meet in the playoffs or something.
Exactly. It's like they just have no luck where they just squeak in, they have a bad season, and then Chicago just easily handles them.
Eats them for breakfast.
And moves on to the next one. So I think it's going to be St. Louis and Anaheim, but Anaheim first and St. Louis second.
St. Louis, Anaheim?
Yeah.
St. Louis first.
Yeah. Anaheim
diagram
first, St. Louis second. That's my pick.
All right, Michael. I'm just going to switch around. As you said, you thought Anaheim's going to dip down. I think Calgary's
going to go up over Edmonton.
Yeah, over Edmonton, exactly. So I'm going to pick Edmonton as number one. St. Louis is number two. I just think Edmonton's kind of slacking a little bit as of late. Obviously, they're a very young team, so you can't really blame them that much. But I think they're slacking. I think they're going to drop down. St. Louis, I've been watching them. They had a pretty good start to the season. You thought, oh, okay, this is going to be the regular St. Louis, win division type thing, or come close to winning division. They've just been falling off a cliff, but started to, kind of right the ship after firing Hitchcock. So I think they're going to outlast LA for that number two spot. I think LA, I was tempted to pick them, but I've watched them, and they just haven't.
Something's
they
missing.
Can't score goals.
Yeah,
they just can't. And
just
they have
not there.
Really. They have one of the most talented teams in the league in terms of offense. They have
Jeff Carter. The greatest player of all time.
Arguably.
Easily.
I got Calgary.
So argue some say it's easy.
Yeah.
All right, so you got Calgary.
Edmonton.
Edmonton. Yeah, I got the exact same thing again. I think our West is identical. I think our whole thing is identical, actually. Didn't you pick Tampa to make it, too?
Yeah.
I think we literally picked the exact same list. Actually, I picked Pittsburgh to go second.
Yeah, that's
all right, so Calgary is going to definitely get bumped up for me. I do think they have the streak in them right now to do it. And Edmonton's in a draw. Break that playoff curse. Drought.
since Ryan's
similar to the Raiders.
But I will say this: I think LA is gonna make a strong push. I think they're gonna be the last team to get eliminated from the playoffs. That's my prediction. But if there's one or more head-to-heads left between St. Louis and LA, I think LA's gonna pull through, win those games, and take that last spot.
Yeah.
But I don't.
Well,
think
they recently played in LA, like.
Yeah, that's why I don't think they're
St.
playing
St.
against each other anymore.
Yeah.
That's why. But
I do want to say this though: if LA does make it, I really think they're gonna go all the way.
That's why I'm not putting them in.
First round,
I don't see them.
First round, Chicago, LA.
Exactly. Then
how,
the winner of that always
good.
Goes on to win it.
That's
so,
true.
Oh, man,
true. That's that's not like our Western Conference
yeah.
final every year.
Yeah.
LA, Chicago.
Yeah.
All right, so I got Edmonton, St. Louis, Edmonton, St. Louis, Anaheim, St. Louis.
Exactly.
Yeah.
That's been the prediction. So now compare your brackets, start joining your pools. Don't blame us if you lose $10.
Nope.
But
more.
Definitely keep watching because more opinions on the way, and check out the upcoming podcast.
Yes,
for,
the reason why we haven't made any videos lately is, well, work, school, been, you know, taking over our lives, but also we've been working on a podcast, special project. It's coming out soon. We're recording it literally as soon as this is done. Should come out a day or two after this video's up.
Yeah.
Stay tuned for that, and we're going to try and do them about once a week. Sports, nerdy stuff, video games, whatever it is. It's going to be just like the rest of our channel, random and sporadic. So stay tuned for that. We have a SoundCloud account, and we will be posting it here on the YouTube channel as well. So we hope you enjoy it.
Follow the links, guys.
Yeah,
they'll
all be in the description below. So again, thanks, guys, for watching. Like the video. Comment your picks. Subscribe if you haven't. And, of course, share with your friends. We always appreciate that sort of thing.
Three-sided box, out.